Let's look at an example of discrete choice analysis in action with a paper by Abelek and Gruber from 2011 in the American Economic Review. They asked, how do senior citizens choose their prescription drug plans? Well, here's the context. In 2003, Medicare expanded to cover prescription drugs. That was called Medicare Part D. Here's how that law worked. It allowed private companies to provide this coverage to senior citizens. So many different plans were offered. In fact, by 2006, the average senior citizen had over 40 plans they could choose from. Now, each of these privately offered plans had to meet a minimal federally set standard, but otherwise they had a lot of flexibility in what they could cover and how much they cost. So in the data, the authors had characteristics of each of these insurance plans, things like the premium, the deductible, the expected out-of-pocket cost, and whether it covered the donut hole, which were expenses not ordinarily covered by Medicaid. They also know which plans each person bought, so we can compute the market share for each of these 40 plans. Now, they use that data to estimate a discrete choice model to figure out people's preferences over each of these plans' characteristics. Now, this discrete choice model is very flexible. It lets people have a different preference for the premium and a different preference for the expected out-of-pocket costs, a different preference for the deductible, etc. So you can care about each one of these different characteristics separately. Now, we might think that people really only care about the total cost of a plan. You know, if I have a bunch of different plans that all have the same amount of coverage, all I really want to pick is the one that I'm going to pay the least for, the cheapest one. I shouldn't care exactly how I'm paying for the plan. You know, so a plan that has a high premium and low out-of-pocket expenses should be about the same to me as a plan that has high out-of-pocket expenses and a low premium, as long as the total cost is the same and they cover the same thing. But nonetheless, in our estimation, when we implement this discrete choice model, we'll allow for people to view the premium and the expected out-of-pocket costs differently, to have different preferences over this, even though that's not what we would expect, okay? What we would expect is that they have the same preferences over these two things, because a dollar is a dollar. Why should I care exactly how I'm spending the dollar for the plan? All I really should care about is the total cost, but we're not imposing that when we estimate people's preferences. So let's see what they found in the data.